Namashivaya students, we will be continuing with our chapter on employment, and we have discussed about the employment and the distribution of male female workers, and today we will be moving forward with the chapter. We will be discussing self-employment and hired workers. So we will be starting with one example that is given in your book. See, it is written here there are three kinds of workers. Let's first discuss about the three kinds of workers. Now in the example, there are it's given one is an owner of a cement shop, another one a worker is actually a construction worker, and another is a civil engineer of a construction company. So we have three kinds of workers. See, all our workers, whether it be a owner of the cement shop owner, or a construction worker, or a civil engineer, all are workers, but their status are different. Now we will be checking their status. Now coming to the first category, see, there are workers who own and operate an enterprise. That means they have their own firm, or they have their own enterprise which they are the owner of it, and then they run that particular enterprise or the firm, and also they earn a living out of it. So what happens, these kind of people are called the self-employed workers. So these are the category, their status is the self-employed workers. So who among the different examples that we have gone through, who will be under this self-employed workers? Obviously the owner of the cement shop is actually a self-employed person. Now previously when we were discussing the category of workers, we have said that a worker is one, we all know, that is one who is engaged in an economic activity. But a person, like, it is not necessarily means that he has to be like getting salary from a particular employer, that he needs to work under an employer. He might own he might have his own business also. So they are called the self-employed workers. So self-employed workers, here we have found out who is the self-employed worker, the cement shop owner. Next, so in India, what we find that half of the workforce in India belongs to this category of self-employed. So this is one kind of a category. Next category of workers is known as the casual wage laborers. What we call it? Casual wage laborers, which is 34% of the total India's workforce. Now let's first look into what is actually this casual laborer. So casual wage laborer, who are called the casual laborers? You know, those who don't have a permanent kind of a job, those who are engaged in activity where their job is not permanent. Today they might be a part of the workforce, tomorrow they might lose their job, they might not have, and for whatever work they do, they get a particular amount of remuneration, they are paid. So there is no guarantee, or they do not have strict work policies, and they don't work like that. They get on, you know, this daily wages. That is, they work for a particular day, they get wages for it. Tomorrow, if they are not working, they are not getting any, they are not getting paid for it. So such are called the casual wage laborers. So these are the second categories. Now when we were talking about the example, we had a cement shop owner and a construction worker. So see, this construction worker will be definitely a casual wage laborer. So when we were talking, this construction, that is the construction worker, he is actually belonging to the category of casual wage laborer. Why he is belonging to the casual wage laborer? Because now the construction is going on, so he has work, he's paid daily wages. And later on, if it is not there, he will not be paid. Next category is the regular salaried employees. Now, regular salaried employees are who? It constitutes about 16% of the total workforce, now of India's workforce. That they are someone who is engaged in a firm, industry or enterprises. He is paid wages for his work, and he is getting a monthly basis. That is, he is a regular salary. When we talk about salary, that means the person is paid on a monthly basis. He is getting regular salaries. This month he will get, next month he will get. He is employed, and he is, you know, basically a part of MNCs, that big companies, firms, industries. So he is a part of it, and he is being regularly paid. Regularly in the sense, monthly basis he will be paid. It's not that today he has a job, tomorrow he will not have. It's not like that. Okay, so these are called the regular salaried people. So who will be a category from this example is the civil engineer. You know, he is employed in a farm and he is getting salaried every month. He's being paid salary every month, so he is a regular salaried employee. So we find that these three different categories, and we have discussed it with examples. So what are the three categories? One is your self-employed workers, second is the casual wage laborers, and the third is your regular salaried people. Now in your book there is a chart been given. See, if you go through the diagram, that is chart, that is a distribution of employment by gender basis. So you have the distribution of employment by gender basis. Now here you find gender means there are the male workers and the female workers. Now we have categorized into three, that is self-employed, regular salaried, casual wage. So in among the male workers you find 32% are casual wage laborers. Okay, then you find self-employed are how many? 50 are self-employed, and regular salaried are how many? Say regular salaried is 18%. So 18% is regular salaried. So this is a example of your male workers distribution of the types, that is self-employed, regular wage salary, and casual. Moving on to the female workers, you again have it, that is 37% of them are casual wage laborers, 53% of them are self-employed, and you have 10% of them who are regularly salaried. So this is the difference between the male workers and the female worker distribution. Now another chart also you have in your book, and that is also where the categories are self-employed, regular salaried, and casual wage laborers, which the terms which we have already discussed. And here it is showing what the distribution of employment by region. By region means we will be dividing it into the urban areas and also the rural areas. So the urban workers and the rural workers. Now in the urban region, the workers distribution or the different kind of employment opportunities that they have is, see, the self-employed are how many? Self-employed are 41%, and regular salaried employment is 41%, and 18% are casual. Obviously in the urban area you will find less of casual laborers, because most of the people are educated, so they are engaged in activities where they are getting salary, or they are self-employed, and less of casual workers in the urban areas you find. Moving on to the rural, see, rural will have more of casual wage laborers. So 39% is casual wage laborers, and 7% are regular salaried employees, and 54% are self-employed. So again here 54% are self-employed. So this is the basically the distribution of employment by region. So distribution of employment by gender we have checked, and then we have checked the distribution of employment and on the basis of this region specific also. See, in the region specific, in the agricultural sector, why casual laborers are more, since majority of the depending on farming, own plots of land and cultivating from there. So they are self-employment is much higher in the rural area. So see, you will be finding self-employment workers are 54%. They are more than the urban areas also. Why? Because there are more opportunities of being self-employed in a rural area. So this is majorly the distribution of self-employed, casual wage laborers, and also the regular salaried workers in India. So go through this and then we will move forward with the chapter. Om Namah Shivaya.